Young learners, you might have heard the phrase, a picture is worth a thousand words. Means, a picture conveys an idea more quickly and effectively than the written words. This phrase is absolutely applicable for posters. Let's see the marking scheme for posters, which comes as question 3 for class 11th and 12th. Format, as you see, is a 1 mark, content of 2 marks, including all the value points, which I'll discuss later. And the third part is expression, which includes grammatical accuracy, coherence, and fluency of ideas. Now you see, what is a poster? First and second, how it is useful? Certainly, posters we have seen on the billboards and some of the hoardings and all. The usefulness, it comes because it creates awareness about current social problems and issues. Posters serve the purpose of notices, advertisements, and invitations. As you can see in the PPT, they are of 3 types. First, invitations, in which it is for carnivals, fests, exhibitions, etc. The second is for social cause, social warnings, creating social awareness, do and don'ts. These come in the category of second type of posters. Last but not the least, it is for exhibitions, workshops, seminars, etc. Here are the value points. You can go through it. First of all, it's very important that it should be in a rectangular box. And the moment you look at the poster, it should be meaningful. It should reflect the purpose through visuals, sketches, matchstick drawings, etc. As you glance, you can see the catchy phrases, words and slogans are mentioned. And I have specially highlighted the 7th point. Though the children use their creativity, they use slogans, they use everything, colors and every form, the fonts, but sometimes some children fail to write the organizer's name or the issuing authority. If this is missing, children, please mind it that you may lose some marks. Before practicing, let's note the format that's required for poster making. First of all, as we see, the title is there. It must be catchy and it should basically suit with the question that has been asked. The second is sketches. You can draw, you can sketch, you can have the matchstick drawings, etc. And if you're not good at, then certainly you may use some slogans, some catchy phrases and your writings so that it becomes little impressive. For example, you can see the beautiful thought-provoking poster on COVID-19 in this upcoming PPT. You can see. And one more point, I want to make it very clear that when you are using date, time and venue, it should only be used when it is meant for any event or for exhibition or workshop. Otherwise, if it is just for creating social awareness or the need for regular exercises, then in such type of things, you can avoid using date, time and venue. Let's move on to the next one. Here are some images. You can very well see the issuing authority, the name of the person is there, the slogan is there, the theme is also very clearly evident when you look at it. Let's have some more. This again, it's about COVID-19. Beautifully, it's day 8, home, quarantine. More posters, you can see it is on eye donation. Beautifully, the eye has been made, very clearly depicted, using the slogans. And mind the children that it is the phrases that has to be written. There must not be long, lengthy sentences. This is COVID-19, wash your hands. Some more example for the sample posters you can have. As you see, it's on communal harmony, the need of the hour, just see the beautiful picture, it's conveying lot of meanings, but it misses something. What is being missed? What are the problems or the mistakes you find in the previous PPT? Think, children, think. What more value points you think that they must be added so that it looks more complete? Yeah, guess right. It should have been, there should have been more slogans, the phrases, and the name of the issuing authority. So if the beautiful picture or the poster is there with sketches, one or two slogans, I'm afraid that you may lose some marks. If the question is of 4 marks, then you may get even 2. So please don't miss out. Do write slogans and never forget to mention the name of the issuing authority or the organization or issued in the public interest. Now, before we go for topic to practice for poster writing, I would like to give a quick recap. Keep in the mind, children, that first of all, a poster is designed to be put up at a public place. So it should be designed in such a way that it may catch the attention of the passers-by. Second, it should always be in bold or capital letters because it is read by the public from a distance. Third, you must not write any extra or irrelevant matter. You should focus on the issue for which it has been prepared. Don't forget to write catchy slogans, attractive language. Last but not the least, never write long, full, lengthy sentences. Use phrases, 3 or 4, enough. And never forget to mention the issuing authority. So we move on to the last part. Here are the few topics to practice for poster writing. If you practice, I'm sure you will gain better. And I firmly believe that practice makes a man perfect. Keep practicing. Stay healthy. Stay tuned. God bless you. Thank you.